Hello students, welcome to the session. What is I was telling you about the what is blood pressure. The blood pressure is a force that blood exert against the wall of the vessels. So this kind of a pressure is known as blood pressure. The blood pressure is much greater in arteries than the veins. Also there is two type of pressure, that is systolic pressure and the diastolic pressure. Systolic pressure is a pressure in which your arteries during the contraction of your the amount of pressure in your arteries during the contraction of your heart muscle. This type of a pressure is known as systolic pressure. And diastolic pressure is the pressure, the amount of pressure in your arteries during the relaxation of your heart muscle. So this type of pressure is known as diastolic pressure. And the normal range of this systolic pressure is 120 mm of mercury, and normal diastolic pressure is 80 mm of mercury. So the instrument used to measure the blood pressure is sphygmomanometer, and the high blood pressure leads to the diseases that is known as hypertension. So this actually result in the increase of resistance to blood flow. It does not actually allow to resistance mean to actually to stop it. So it actually increase the resistance to blood flow. So this can also lead to the internal bleeding or rupture of your arteries. So here is two type of tubes that is artery and veins. What is arteries? Arteries are the vessels which carry blood away from the heart to various organs. So that means this actually carries oxygenated blood to all parts of the body from the heart. So this is actually arteries have a thick walls and elastic walls. Veins actually collect the blood from different organ and bring it back to the heart. That means it carries deoxygenated blood. So that's it. What are capillaries? The smallest vessels have walls which are one cell thick. This is known as capillaries. These are the capillaries. So on reaching an organ or tissue, the arteries divide into smaller and smaller vessels. So these smaller and smaller vessels leads to capillaries, and the capillaries then also join together to form veins that convey the blood away from the organ or tissue. So here, maintenance of platelets. What is platelets? Platelets is also a part of blood. Platelets actually useful whenever we have a bleeding, we have an injury. So naturally the loss of blood from the system has to be minimized, and it is minimized by the help of platelets. So platelets blood has a platelet which circulate around the body, and it actually plug these leak by helping to clot the blood at the point of injury. So the clotting of blood is actually done by the help of platelet cells. So now, what is lymph? There is another type of fluid involving transportation. This type of fluid is called as lymph, or we can say that the tissue fluid. Lymph has a functional role. It is a colorless liquid and contain a less protein. Also, this lymph has a various function. That is, lymph carries digested and absorbed fat from intestine and drains excess fluid from extracellular space back into the blood. So this is all about lymph. Lymph also have a role in capturing the bacteria and bring to the lymph node, and where these bacteria are destroyed. So there are two functions. I told you that one is to carries digested and absorb fat from the intestine, and also another one is to capture the bacteria and bring them to the lymph node and get them destroyed. This is all about the lymph. please go through, and if you have a question, you can ask me. Thank you.